I'm just going to jump right in. This film is about a building which is going to be under construction soon. It's a building I designed, well, designed, did the construction documents for, and permitted as a one-man operation, if I can toot my own horn. But really, these problems are not so difficult to solve, they're just extremely labor-intensive. The difficulty arises from the challenge of having meaningful ideas about structure and human inhabitation and concretizing these into built form. So everything you see and are about to see, drawings, physical model, digital models, are all made by me. There were a few consultants on board, a civil engineer who did the structural calculations and added this moment frame you see here to resist the lateral forces, a geotechnical engineer for the soils report, and a gentleman who did our Title 24 energy calculations, which went well because I designed the building with solar orientations considered, like any true architect would. But architects never make a fuss about this because it's boring. But I make a point of talking about this to resist this image that the world has of architecture that it's a type of decoration. So, without further ado.
The design of this house is extremely site-specific. Some architects, the context is arbitrary. The building's an autonomous object. To other architects, context is everything. And studying these architects, I realized that for this house, I wanted to design it from the inside out. But context is still key.
This is the context. There's the existing building, this two-story one, which is going to be demolished, sadly, even though it's really not doing too well. We're in Manhattan Beach, California, which has tremendous upsides. Great weather, it's usually about 10 degrees Fahrenheit cooler than inland SoCal. It's walkable, you can get from residential zones to commercial zones, restaurants, things like that, very easily on foot. Pretty quickly. You can get to the beach easily. You can walk to the beach. Most of the houses view the water. This house is no exception. It's designed for that. And there are also some downsides like the parking issue and the coastal climate, which is pretty corrosive to a lot of building materials. Like a lot of the wood around here will rot and a lot of the metals will rust.
So I went through plenty of these formal iterations, but I chose the materiality early on based on what would really last in that kind of climate. Stucco, great in that kind of weather. Copper will patina as a protective layer, and it will not rust and decay. Well, there is some steel that's exposed, the steel moment frame. I love steel structure. I'm gonna be honest here, it looks too awesome to not expose. But that's gonna be prime painted and treated, so you won't have to worry about it much more than anything else. You see it here in the most recent version, painted in black. And people respond psychologically well to seeing structure and how things work, so it's not just the aesthetic argument, which it never is for me. When you look at this, you may notice emphasis on the form above. It's emphasized by cantilever at the front, it's pushed in to mark the entry and extends out above. At the back, it's pushed in to add some square footage to this backyard space, which is very limited. But the form above is also emphasized programmatically, meaning the important functions are placed above, bedrooms, living, dining, kitchen, and what you can deal with being flooded, hopefully not, is placed at the ground level. And this is generally good practice when you're by the beach. So the two-car garage is at the front here, and at the back there's a guest quarters, which will not always be in use. The main entry is here on the second floor, which may have sounded quite strange if I didn't have this prelude. These are kind of pseudo Spanish steps, which are necessary for circulation, but also possibly a space to inhabit in themselves. And the second floor has the bedrooms, and the third floor has a living, dining, and kitchen, because that's where you really get the view of the water, and that's a common strategy that's used here. I'm trying to have a part-to-whole relationship in which all the parts are similar, related, yet different. I think that's one of the things that makes certain bodies of work contemporary architecturally and not, you know, modern or postmodern. Now the view of the water is from this elevation to the southwest. Why is that important? Because typically when you're building in LA, you don't want too much glass on the south or the west, but that's where the view is, so you have to have it. So how do I deal with this? The same way anybody who knows what they're doing deals with it. Cantilever above the glass. That way the winter sun, when it's lower and you wouldn't mind it coming in, comes right in. The summer sun is higher and gets blocked out by the cantilever, doesn't come directly into the glass, because that's the sun that's going to give you the heat intake and the glare. In some parts of the world, you would like the sun coming directly in, but not here. I know you don't love me, but you don't have to be so mean. I know you don't love me, but you don't have to be so mean. Treat me like the worst thing you ever seen. Treat me like the worst thing you ever seen. Here you see this angled cut at the third floor, which is the trajectory of the view into the water. Here at its maximum height is where you have the greatest view. And it's at the exterior of the balcony to really optimize that. Treat me like a low-down stupid fool. Treat me like a low-down. Manhattan Beach, unlike much of LA, is very human scale and very walkable. And with this house, I tried to address that by having it articulate multiple parts at the ground level where people are going to be walking by the sidewalk at human scale. And even above, it's articulated with these segments, while most houses would consolidate into larger masses above. And this geometry makes its way onto the interior, breaking things down into dimensions that are comfortable to the human body.
Behind me is the site. The previous building is now demolished. The city was really strict when it came to design, construction documents, permitting. They wanted to see the exact slope on every square inch of the property for runoff, every single balcony drain detail, overflow details. They required this green fence to be up before getting the building permit, before even talking about construction. But it's for good reason. The houses are so much closer to each other here than they are in most of LA. Most of LA, where the process would have been a bit easier. And think I got some pretty interesting results.
I'm trying to deal with geometry, trying to deal with space, to create space that's pleasant to the human body, trying to deal with ecologies, trying to create forms that conserve energy, that are energy efficient, trying to have conscious ideas about human inhabitation. Yet when I talk about these things, people look at me like I'm crazy. Like, you're supposed to deal with aesthetics and the way things look. I'm sorry, that's not what I'm interested in. It will have a certain aesthetic, yes, but as a byproduct of these issues. And you may like the way it looks, you may not like the way it looks, that's subjective. But usually in my experience, when you learn about how it works, why it is the way it is, if it's a piece of architecture, usually you will start to like the way it looks, or most people will, because it's attached to performative aspects. If you enjoyed the video, subscribe. I'm working on more content, but it's a slow process, so who knows when it'll be up here. But I constantly update my Instagram, so also follow me there at arahovsepyan. That's A-R-A-H-O-V-S-E-P-Y-A-N. Take care. Peace.